So maybe it's better to spend a few time on this slide. Because in this slide, we have the typical usage of the Future Gateway out so far. So we have on top the final user. And the final user can exploit APIs with the Liferay portal and its portlets. You can see the green box on the left. And this first approach is the typical approach provided by the Catania Sense Gateway framework. In the middle, the final user can deal directly with a community, a generic kind of community portal. So inside that portal, it is possible to develop a web application portlet or any kind of web plus AJAX call. It is possible to communicate with the API server, front-end and daemon. And the other possible way to use the APIs provided by the Future Gateway is by mobile or desktop applications. In such a case, you may be linked with an existing portal. You can see those gray lines linking a portal with a mobile desktop application. Or you can directly contact the API server, front-end and daemon. So how final users can interact with the APIs, with the REST APIs? Let's start from how the Catania Sense Gateway framework was managing the authentication and the authorization. And then we will see the differences with the Future Gateway. So we have on the left, the user that is contacting the portal, is connecting to the portal. The portal provides the identity provider authentication interface. So typically, you are prompted to type your username and password. So the identity provider authenticates the user. And then the portal contacts if the authentication is good. So the portal will contact an LDAP server in order to get the user authorization records. Then the user can the portal will generate token in order to contact the API server. So this is the way the Catania Sense Gateway framework can be used as well to use the API, the REST API calls provided by the API, by the Future Gateway. So in Indigo, you can see in the top of the slide there is the link of deliverable that explains this solution. We decided to use the portal, to link the user with the portal in order to be authenticated and authorized. The user connects to the portal. The portal provides, again, a login screen to the user. And as soon as the user is logged in successfully, we'll provide a token. This token is used by the Future Gateway with the services exposed by the portal. That is the red ball token check. The token check verifies if the token is good or not. And if it is successful, send it to the Future Gateway, so to the REST engine. This is the same way to explain this mechanism. So the user contacts the Indigo EIM system. In Indigo, the authorization and the authentication component is named EIM. This component is returning the token is sent from the portal to the API server. The API server checks the validity of this token for each REST call. And if the token is good, the API server will send this token to the resources, and the resources can be accessed or not accordingly to the authorization information contained in the token. So beside the Indigo mechanism and the way the Catania Sensor Gateway framework is managing the authentication and the authorization, the Future Gateway is providing a baseline authorization and authentication mechanism. It's a very simple way thought for all those situations where users don't have any kind of authorization and authentication mechanism. So the principle is very simple. You have to share a common key between the component that is authenticating the user and the API server. There is a special configuration parameter for that. So the user first has to authenticate. The key encrypts the username, password, and timestamp information of this so-called log this information inside the so-called log token. And the log token is sent to a special API entry point to the API server frontend. The log token is analyzed by the server, identifies a registered user inside the API server, and a session token will be generated if the user is successfully mapped. This session token will be used later to interact with any further REST call. So at the moment, the Future Gateway has been implemented in several situations. At the beginning, in November of last year, it has been presented on the AGI Community Forum with a demonstrative portal. So I developed the so-called Hello World application that was using the Grid and Cloud engine and with its SSH adapter to send a simple Hello World job. And another more complex portlet called NS, providing a complex user interface and again executing something on via SSH with the Grid and Cloud engine. Later in February, during the CloudScape conference in Brussels, we demonstrated two Indigo use cases. The first called Molecular Dynamics. This was using, again, the Grid and Cloud engine, using its ROCCI JSAG adapter. So we had a Docker container providing all the software for this Molecular Dynamics. The Future Gateway APIs were capable to instantiate the VM according to an input, execute the Molecular Dynamic case, and retrieve back the results of this execution. The second demonstration was the so-called climate change. This use case will be shown by next presentations, so we'll not spend so much words here. By the way, it's using again the Grid and Cloud engine. It is using its SSH adapter to execute something on a virtual machine. But in this case, execution requests are piloted by the so-called Ophidia, no, sorry, Kepler, that is a workflow management system. So after this presentation in CloudScape, a further development has been done with the Molecular Dynamics case when we started to use Indigo services through the TOSC adapter. We developed its first implementation, and we called it Simple TOSCA. And Simple TOSCA just requires a YAML file containing the description of what you are requesting. So in this case, the Docker instance, the Docker container containing all the software components. And we were successfully demonstrating also that was possible to target with the Future Gateway also the TOSCA orchestrator component coming from Indigo experience. Just to have a look on what is going inside for instance, in molecular dynamics, we have an external a community portal on top of this slide, the Amber Web GUI. This user interface is exploiting the Future Gateway REST APIs. The Future Gateway takes the requests, contacts the grid engine. The grid engine is exploiting the JSAGA library. JSAGA library is contacting the adapter, in this case, the ROCCI. The adapter is contacting the OpenStack instance. The OpenStack is opening the molecular dynamic container. And then via the SSH, still piloted by the ROCCI adapter, is executing the molecular dynamic job. And then the I/O staging component of the JSAGA is again providing back the results to the grid engine interface. So it seems quite complicated. A lot of interaction are available here. But if you see, when I switched this situation with the new JSAGA adapter, you can see the difference, very little, because the only thing that is changing is the TOSCA component. TOSCA component is behaving totally different, but from the API point of view, the situation doesn't change at all. So the calls remain the same, while what is happening under the hood is totally different. So TOSCA, as Jacinto shown us before, TOSCA is contacting the IAM. The IAM instantiates the container for us, and TOSCA component is interacting with the SSH as soon as the container is available and execute the molecular dynamics job. So the Future Gateway is also providing some tools for development. All source code is available on GitHub. You can see the link. And it is possible to start developing on it just installing the Future Gateway. Installation scripts are available. You can install very easily on a standalone Ubuntu server 14.04 or inside Ubuntu 14.04 Docker image. Or you can even use the AGI Fed Cloud infrastructure. There exists an appliance for that. There are also facilities to update the software packages, keep aligned the database schema with the new software versions. And there are also some development tools to customize the code. I will show you also this in the very technical presentation.